Hello, you two. I am Lachey, abbreviation LS. Hello, everyone. I am back. Sorry, I did not do a video clip yesterday. Like I already told you guys on my last video, I would be very busy. It ended up being true. I was very, very busy. So now I'm doing a video. What's funny is I was not so busy today, but I got motivated because I wanted to make sure the video clip was on here. So anyway, I am on another topic. Excited about that. Woo! So I'm hoping they're watching the videos of my revival of the week. I will continue as I have topics to talk about. This time it is about Christians versus spiritual. And that should be a good topic. Yeah. Hope a lot of people watch this video because it's a lot to be said. I'm going to say a prayer before I begin. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread as we forgive us our debt, as we forgive us our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory is forever. Woo! Woo! Chapters and verses to go with this topic. My first one is Acts 11:26. And the other one is First Corinthians chapter 2, verse 11. I'm not going to read them, but I'm just using because those are my two verses that I will be using for my topic on Christian versus spiritual. Christians are people that believe in going to a religious, part of a religious, part of a church, and follow someone that teaches in the church. That's what a Christian is. But then there's other meanings for Christian. Christian means that you live and serve God. That's another thing to stay off for Christian. Some people think, oh, I go to church and I'm a Christian, da 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 da. Just because you go to church does not necessarily mean that you are a Christian. The real meaning of Christian is accepting God in your life and living and serving the Lord in the right path of righteousness. That's what Christian means. Spiritual means that person not necessarily go to a church or is a part of a religion. They just live and serve God and believe in Him. Some of us read our Bibles. Some of us are heavy on prayer. And those are people that are spiritual. That's why we are called. Why we say we're spiritual. Because we believe in God and we believe in serving Him and walking and talking and living for Him. And some of us either read our Bibles or read devotion or involve in a study group of spiritual surroundings. And the only reason why I like to talk about these two big things, because it gets close to the holidays, everybody wants to pretend like they're really doing good. And these holidays are not meant for that. Like, for example, Thanksgiving. You should be thankful all the time. You should be thanking God all the time. And I don't care which one you are, Christian or you're spiritual. If you love God and you're serving Him, you should be thanking Him every day. There's no such thing as, only thank Him on a specific day or specifically 1 month you say thanks for everything. I mean, I see that on Facebook a lot. A lot of people like to advertise the reason why they're thankful. I say thank you to God every day. Thank you for the clothes on my back. Thank you for the food I eat. Thank you for the little bit of healing I have. I thank you for allowing me to have that gift to be able to sign. I thank Him for allowing me to be strong as a woman. I thank you for allowing me to live. There's a lot to be thankful for. That's why I say in the Christian and spiritual world, they're almost the same. The only difference is spiritual people may not consider going to church on a regular day or being a part of a church or becoming a member of a church. But Christians, they will consider going to church, being a part of a church, and becoming a member of a church, and that's the difference. That's a different situation. But that's fine if that's what you choose. But don't, you know, I never understood how Christians want to pick on the spirit people that are spirit. Just because you believe in going to church don't mean you need to criticize those who are spiritual. Spiritual people are doing the stuff that you're doing. The only thing is they're just not going to church. And they may not be surrounded with other people that are spiritual because they're not attending a church where more people are part of God in that. But it's okay. We get our way differently. Ours may be through our family, through friends that we know that are already spiritual and to help us in our walk. But being criticizing people that are spiritual and prefer to be spiritual and prefer not to go to church, you don't need to criticize them. They're doing exactly what you're doing. The only difference is they're just not going to church, and that's okay. That is their choice. God is everywhere. He is everywhere. God is everywhere. Believe it or not, He's in your bathroom. He's in your shower. He's in your bedroom. He's in your car. He's everywhere. Why? Because He's inside your soul. He's a part of your spirit. The part that I like to ask people is, whether you are Christian or spiritual, how serious are you in the walk for the Lord? Do you present Him in everything you do? Some of us don't. So we can't really be criticizing, she don't go to church and she keeps saying she led the Lord, and I can't be tired of hearing her say that. But that's another thing people misunderstand. Just because you're spiritual don't mean you have to stop everything in your life, cutting everything off. That's not what God is asking. Put him in part of your life, in everything. I'm going to use people that drinks and smokes and pot. I'm going to use those type of people. They think, we become a Christian or we live spiritual, we won't be able to do the things we love to do. No, God is asking you to take these things in consideration. Use these things in moderation. As the more that we tend to do that, we will feel better about ourselves. I'm not telling you to cut off drinking, but you also have to remember, drinking can get you, can make you turn you to be evil. When we drink too much, or we overly drink, I need a drink, or drinking that heavy liquor. We gotta think about that. These things are serious. So we need to be careful how we do that, and we need to think. Are we taking this serious? Are we taking this serious with God? I'm not going to tell you that I don't drink right here. But I also think that if we don't use it in moderation, how we do things in life, that means we don't care how God sees us, and that's bad. I care about what He sees in me. I want to be so strong in the spirit. So of course, I eliminate many things I do in my life. I don't enjoy going to the club, so I've cut that off. If I go, it's probably because I'm just socializing with friends. Or family. But other than that, I will not go for myself or with my partner. I'm not going to waste my time going to do that. Because I know how people act in the clubs, in the party, but I'm not telling you to cut it off. Just remember, as a Christian, as a spiritual person, you need to think. Is this what God wants for you? And to think about how much you're doing it. Smoking is another one. Oh, smoking is not good. Yeah, but it also damages your body. It kills your health. We need to think about that. I mean, the more that we eliminate the bad habits, the better we develop our spirit with God, whether you're a Christian or spiritual. We start seeing and doing and living for God. We will see a lot of changes. I don't care what the world thinks of me, because I ask for forgiveness every day, and I also say thank you every day for letting me live, and try to show and walk and talk in the spiritual of my day-to-day, my basic, my day. Now I try to continue on doing that to help others to see my shine. And I hope you see it too. No one should be criticizing anyone, but you're not perfect either. You shouldn't be talking about them not going to church and stuff. Hey, that may be what you want, but that may not be what they want. God gave us a choice of what we want. We got to remember that. Always remember that. I believe that if you prefer to go to church and be surrounded with others that love the Lord and like to be together and united with other people that are Christians, that's fine. But if you're a person that prefers spiritually doing these things at home, praying and sharing the words to others, we all go through something in life with our spiritual walk. So there are many ways to share your testimony, but you just got to know where to share them. And sometimes you could be helping someone if you never realizes you're helping. I try my best to share my experience. And like I said, I'm not perfect, and I'm not against religion. I just don't feel religious understand that everyone do not want to be a part of your church. And I'm sorry, there are some that are very, very aggressive, expecting you to be part of their church. There's no saying nowhere in this Bible that God is forcing you to serve them in that way. Nowhere in the Bible is of that. So I always wonder why we have people like that. Oh well, God said this and that and that. Don't lie to yourself. Don't pretend. Don't pretend. You're not fooling no one. And for me, I grew up in a church, so I already know what these people do. Some of you guys are very fake in the church. I get the Holy Ghost reason. I'm going to use yesterday. Till this day, I enjoy how that works. And a lot of people think, oh, if I, and I'm sorry, because I have gone to a Baptist church growing up, you always got one person trying to fall out. But to this day, so fake. Be real. I know when someone's really got the Holy Ghost, it's a different feeling when you see it. And you really will now when you see it. Now, I'm explaining my story about yesterday. God works miracles. I live in an area where AC's got to be run more than normal. And if you want one of those people that can't stand the heat, or can't stand the room being stuffy, I'm one of them. I can't stand it. So, having your AC, acting like he doesn't want to work, you're going crazy in your mind. Oh, Lord, what am I going to do? God's really talking to you, but you ain't knowing that. You're too busy thinking, oh, how am I going to get this fixed? Oh, my God, it's so expensive. Oh, listen to him. He comes through you in a whisper. He whispered to you in your ears. Yes, you may have two voices. The one that's saying negative, you got to know that one. But that's Satan. Of course, he's going to always be negative. He's going to have to buy you an AC or get that thing fixed like you should have done it. But the voice kept saying, continually saying, God kept saying, I got your back. Remember that breaker that you turned off the other day? I said, yeah. Well, when you wake up in the morning, turn that back on. And see if that might be the solution. He already knew the answer. But not Lachey. She wasn't listening. She was too busy in the bed. Oh, how I'm going to get this face. Oh, you know, that outfit, I can't stand it. That's why I say we spiritual people need to learn to depend on those positive whispers in our ears. Because that's the spirit talking to you. And we need to listen to it and follow that. It's like when we have an incense. Usually the first one is the correct one. But when we ignore it and go to second, third, and fourth, of course they all ain't gonna work because they ain't not what God wanted you to do in the first place. we really, really take the time to listen to our spirits talking to us, we'll be able to see life a little better. I can say that, yes, yes, yes. I can say that, yes, yes. But, that morning, yesterday morning, I woke up and I went ahead and I went to the breaker box and checked it, and I saw, yes, it was moved because I had turned it off, one part of it, but didn't realize that had something to do with the AC, which I didn't know. So I turned it back on, automatically my AC turned back on. I'm like, I was jumping and screaming and dancing. Woo! And that's why I say, you know when someone is doing the Holy Ghost. I would say the Holy Ghost, because God is good. And you will know. But the reaction won't be falling on the same person over and over, or expecting you to catch him. You're not going to be worried about that. When the Holy Ghost hits you, you're not going to be thinking about who you're going to fall on, what you're going to do. It's going to take control of you, the Spirit of God. God is good. And yes, like I said, I experienced for myself, I know what happens when you feel the Holy Spirit. When you feel the Holy Ghost, you're doing other things. And I still couldn't believe the AC running. I still was like, and I kept on saying, thank you, Jesus. Woo! God is good. He's always on time. The one thing I will say under this topic, take the time to ask yourself this. And I'm only going to say this because many of you say you are Christian or spiritual. Have you already accepted God in your life? And if you're interested in wanting to accept God in your life or want to know how, then get on your knees and ask God, please forgive me for all of my sin. And you became saved. Woo! By God. Read Acts 16, verse 30. And that will explain that. But also John chapter, let me get the verse I have all highlighted. Let me see. So we're going on John chapter 3. Verse 16. To understand what God's only Son did for us. And that way we understand that. I enjoy this topic. Like I said, don't criticize those who prefer to be called spiritual. say that the fairy be spiritual. And spiritual people should not complain if they want to say they're Christian. That's your choice. So be it. Nobody cares. Just make sure that you understand the meaning behind those two words. You a Christian? Okay. That means you accepted God in your life. Okay. And you preferred to attend some kind of church or religious. Okay. Spiritual. You're going to live the life for Jesus, walking and talking of God. We really depend on our spirits. We try to feel it, hear it, see it, do it. And because of that, that shines. Prison has a similar of what I just said, but they're more involved in some type of religion or church. Of someone who's a pastor preaching the message of God. There's nothing wrong with that. I respect that. Respect on that. But once again, do not criticize what we choose and prefer to be what we call that. Anyway, you all have a beautiful day. Some of you guys are probably at night already. Some places are afternoons. So, anyway, guys, have a wonderful day. Enjoy yourselves.